01855 Major John Stephen Holcomb, you are sentenced to dismissal from the Defense Forces.
Major John Stephen Oluka and Major Zadok Abo were sentenced by the General Court Martial sitting in the Somali capital, Mogadishu. They were both found guilty of one count of cowardice in action contrary to the UPDF Act of 2005. Sitting at the headquarters of the UPDF Sector 1 contingent, the Army Court then dismissed the two military officers. Oluka was also found guilty of another count on offences by a person in command when in action. In May, a group of Al-Shabaab militants attacked the Bulomarer forward operating base and killed over 50 soldiers. In court, the prosecution team argued that the two military officers received intelligence briefing from an intelligence officer and the battalion commander about an impending attack from the Al-Shabaab. Prosecution added that the two officers failed to plan and deter the attack. When the attack actually happened, the officers reportedly failed to encourage the soldiers under their command to fight courageously and instead abandoned their troops and fled to Golwayn forward operating base.
Evidence that was brought before the court, a poor command and control, was one of the major factors, but there were other factors as well. A failure to protect raw materials include losing arms and ammunition, illegal possession of ammunition, failure to do any act necessary to protect arms and ammunition, among others. We have heard and concluded 6 cases. The 7th one will be concluded when we go back.
On the second count of offences of persons in command when in action, prosecution stated that Oluka caused the abortion of an operation by the Rare Protection Force to search, rescue and recapture Bulomarer. After listening to both sides, Mugabe sentenced the two military officers to dismissal from the army.
Officers, of course, should be selected according to the command capabilities. And even commanders should be able to train with their soldiers so that they can build the cohesion and teamwork while in the mission area. My final word about this is that, as I said, no one is above the law. There is need to be disciplined while we are serving our country.
There were non-commissioned officers who were also sentenced in Mogadishu. Lance Corporal Alex Okot Anyata was sentenced to 16 years, 7 months and 20 days in jail for failing to protect war materials. Corporal Haggai Twinemanzi was sentenced to 22 years, 9 months and 24 days in jail for the same offence. Others jailed for the same offence are Sergeant Ronald Obeyo, 17 years, 6 months and 19 days, and Sergeant William Kakoza, 10 months and 18 days. Report by Charles Etukuri for the news.